Hey everyone, Marinus here. This is a tutorial on how to warp songs for Synth Riders, Beat Saber, and other rhythm music games. So, for some reason, warping intimidates a lot of people. Don't be intimidated, it's really not that hard. So, first thing is you need to get Reaper. It's a good audio program. It is free to download. It's officially, it's a limited free trial. Unofficially, it is an unlimited free trial. But even in full registration, only costs $60. I bought my copy. I love the software. Also, Synth Riders webpage and you can go to this wiki here. Everything you need to know about mapping, fantastic knowledge base. In that is a link here to the BSMG wiki page for advanced audio editing. You see advanced audio editing, there's variable BPM, a page here for clicking, warping with Reaper, and this has really good information too. So highly recommend going here using this as a reference. Also, there's a really good YouTube tutorial out from the Tech Butterfly. Recommend watching that one as well. I have a couple other tricks that I want to show you here that I think will make your life easier and more. But to start off, so the music that I'm picking here is a live track from Pennywise. So you hear live track, it's going to need warping. They're not playing to a metronome. And sure enough, coming to Air Vortex, check it out. 189, 183, 185. Yeah, that is indicative of a variable BPM. It's also significantly faster than the 168 BPM of their studio track, so anything we might have known about it goes right out the window. So, all right, so when you get Reaper, it's pretty straightforward. New project tab, because new project, item, or sorry, insert media file. Insert the media file, pick your source MP3, better quality the better. And boom, and you will get this. So the very first thing I always do is zoom in. So I will click this plus on the vertical slider here and blow that up as big as I can. And I'm gonna come in here and zoom in a little bit more so we can get some more fidelity. So looking at this, this is just a mess. This is pretty common for a lot of rock and all punk, and it's just a mess. Really hard to see any visual references here to warp to. Fortunately, we don't have to try. Go into options, peak display mode, and change that to show spectrogram and peaks. And now you get this beautiful color graph. So what this is actually representing is the various frequency spread within the music as a heat chart. The different colors represent how bright it is. But you don't need to know exactly how they're calculating this. Know that, and now you can look at this and you can see we got these bright yellow lines in here. Those tend to align very closely with beats. Now you need to be careful because oftentimes they won't be strictly on the beat. They'll be at, you know, an eighth and a half. You know, they'll have pauses in there, so you got to be careful which of these you warp to. But with a good ear, you can figure it out. Sit down with the sheet music. There's other tricks. A lot of songs really are simple. You just grab it and warp it. I've done plenty like that. But we'll go from there. So the first thing you need to do in Reaper to get started is you need to go into the project settings, and you need to set the BPM. In this case, we've worked out. I want to do this one at 189. I'm going to leave it at 4/4. Now this part is very important. This beats position and length, you need to change this to time. If you do not change this to time, instead of just changing this stuff up here, it will stretch your entire song. You don't want to do that. We just want to change the BPM. So change this to time, BPM, and click enter. And now this has now changed to 189 BPM. So normally in here I go and, next step, see the snap enabled here, the sideways U, turn that off. That is really annoying. I don't know why it's enabled by default. Now you can click on here, we can take these, we can kind of drag them So this is like the 15th measure, aligning that one up with the 15th measure. And then we can kind of look and verify. So 15th measure is lining up, 16th measure is lining up. 17th is a little bit off, 18th is lining up. So there may be some complexity in the music there. Yeah, we'll see as time goes on, but generally speaking, it looks like this BPM is going to be pretty close, that we can work to it. Yeah, it's looking pretty close. Okay. So the next thing you want to do to get started is make sure that you don't have any notes playing before 2 seconds. Synth Riders will not let you place a note before 2 seconds, and it's really frowned on a Beat Saber. In this case, the first note is coming right about here. So if we left the default, tried to put a note here, first off, it would be out of sync because these aren't lining up. Second off, that note comes before 2 seconds. So we want to slide a little bit. I'm not going to worry too much about this here. We'll come back to that later. I may not show that in this video. But I do want to pick some good spots to work to. So in this case, since... Well, let's go ahead and listen to it. We'll see where it picks up. So right here, this looks like the start of a measure. Although it's hard to tell. But I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to try to line this one up here, because it's easiest if you line up with the major. So that way, if they do have, you know, weird 16th, weird structure inside the measure, it's easier to see where that is and go outside and grab the ones that are going to line up with the measures. I'll go back and play that again quick. Although actually, I don't think that's right. I think it actually starts here. So I'm gonna go and we'll drag that one back. Drag that to line up with 15.1. Now this was not quite lining up with 7.1, but that's not unsurprising, because anytime I see these fast drum rolls in a punk song, they tend to screw up their timing. Not that they screw it up, but the drummers will often actually play faster than the rest of the song. So these tend to be sections we need to warp out. But I digress, we're getting too far. So to start warping, so we've lined that up nice. It is on the first measure. Now we're going to set up a warping line. So I'm going to hit Shift W. You can't see my keyboard, but Shift W, and you see this little arrow lined up. So that is our first shift point. And we're going to come out here to the end of the seventh measure. We could go to the sixth too, but that's right in the middle of the drum. It's usually better to go like as far out as you can, so you can kind of average it, because musicians, like everyone else, they're not perfect. So each of these can be slightly off beat to beat. So don't be surprised if you're not able to map every single one exactly to the measure. If it's pretty close, it's going to sound good. Nobody's going to notice. In fact, just general warping, if you warp this properly, it will be virtually impossible to notice you've done a thing. So don't worry that you're going to mess up the music by it. You're really not. So I'm going to come on here. I'm going to hit Shift W again, and now we have our second warp marker. So we have two. So what warping does is, now I'm grabbing this. I'm holding my left mouse button, and now we can compress it. And we can stretch it. And see, it's moving the things further apart. So fortunately, Reaper actually will pitch match. So it's not going to make the song higher or lower pitched. It just makes it come together quicker or slower. So I'm going to move this out and go and line that with 7.1. And now this section is lined up. And you can see, look in the middle. Each of these are now lining up pretty good. And in fact, even the drums look like these are lining up pretty much at the 16th that's in the middle. And then we'll go out a few more measures and look at it again. So going out further, and it is helpful to count, because it's sometimes hard to tell, is that, you know, is that note pushed forward, you need to warp it back, or, you know, you push that left or right. So we're clicking here. So it looks like they've slowed down a little bit. Not a whole lot of point of reference in here. We've got another line here. That looks like that slowed down a bit, and then so on. So it looks like a clear line. So there's other lines you can match too, like often. I don't see too many. Like right here, you don't see a bright yellow line, but you do see a change. All of these are indications that things have happened. So depending on what audibly you're trying to warp to, you can cue off of those. So in this case, I know we're a little bit slower. So this line right here should line up with 9.1. So I'm gonna hit Shift W, gonna grab it, and I'm gonna slide that back. And now that's lined up, those are looking lined up, and so on. We would just continue through this entire track like that. This one, it's hard to see, because some of these are actually looking pretty close to right on beat. May not need to warp much at all. 1, 12, 1, 13, 1. So come out here. Yeah, some of this stuff is getting hard to see. That does increase the difficulty. But you can take other cues. So if you see like kind of a nondescript block here, but you see peaks in the waveform up here, you can warp to that. Everything you do, you just come in, like if we're going to warp this one, I'm going to click it, Shift W, stretch it out, and we'll pull it over. If you notice, this is like, you can see, I can't remove my mouse, but like a 0.9 stretch marker, it's warping that 1%. This one, it warped, it stretched the 1, 2%, compressed the other one. You're not going to hear that. So now let's go and test. I'm going to turn on the metronome. So I'm going to put the cursor here before the section we warped. I'm going to go into Options, Metronome Enable. Now, the default settings for the metronome are really quiet, so I like to go into the metronome and pre-roll. This is the primary beat. I'm just going to crank the volume up to, I'll go a little bit over. I could play it up a year. It's not too important. We just want to be able to hear the metronome. And now we can hit Space, and we'll overlay with the metronome and make sure that it fits. If you accidentally warp to the wrong line, it will be blatantly obvious with the metronome on. And this actually sounds pretty good. So that mapped pretty good. And coming out here, it looks like they got pretty close to 190 playing through here. So it may be pretty easy to warp the rest of it. For the sake of argument, we'll pretend that I have finished warping the song, that I clipped the stuff at the end. I'm going to go now, want to render it, want to make that OGG file that I can import into the beatmap editor. So I'm going to go in, hit render, none wrote, go down here. You need to change it to OGG Vorbis. That is important, OGG Vorbis. That will save your OGG file. The quality, up to you. I usually just leave it as default 0.70, which works pretty well for high quality source. If it's a low quality source, you can get away with a smaller file, you know, 0.4, 0.5, something like that. But that's pretty good. And then just click, hit render, and it will create your OGG file, and you are good to go. So I hope that has helped you. Best of luck with mapping. Look forward to playing all your songs.